Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Good performances thus far. The last one was very scary. This one is not going around to the lost. We might have Blue Baby again. We had some scary Blue Baby runs. Well, a scary Blue Baby run semi-recently. Curse of the Blind is a little scary. JSRL or ERVL in a game? What could be better? Alright. This doesn't bother me, actually. You know, if I'm always going to be talking about, oh, the most important thing is said to have survivability right off the bat, then this is fine. Blue Baby with 3 Spirit Hearts, as Blue Baby is wont to be, is actually fairly good. Obviously, the risk associated with it is, no, I can't believe that actually fucking worked. I was sure I was going to hit myself. The risk is inherent with the Curse of the Blindness that we've got going on, and also the fact that you can't replenish our Spirit Hearts, but luckily we found a curse room that allowed us to break even. I don't know when I'm going to use this pill. I'm trying to think of like why I wouldn't just use it right now. I guess if it's telepills, you'd rather have a chance to get the boss room. Let's just take it. It's health up. Sure, that's fine. Now we know, and that's got to be like a... Like, that's never going to become a health downgrade for us, because we are Blue Baby. So if it was a health downgrade, it would have just been... Or it will always be a health upgrade for us, because it's never like we're going to get red hearts. Unless we respawn with Judas's Shadow and then pick up some HP, or we respawn with Lazarus Rags. I honestly have no idea. Well, there goes that Spirit Heart. Easy come, easy go. Do a little bit more exploration. This is interesting. Would I rather have Bob's Rotten Head for that, or would I rather have Bob's Rotten Head for the Widow? Well, the Widow would die, probably in one Bob's Rotten Head. They should really just call it Bomb's Rotten Head. I know that there's, like, you know, an inclination that there might be a Bob lore or a little bit of Bob transforming happening in Afterbirth. I don't know. But I'm going to call it Bomb's Rotten Head because it just feels better coming out of my mouth. Which, for some reason, is a very awkward sentence to say. But anyway, also I'm harboring perhaps a desire that we'll be lucky enough to get... Cricket's head or something ridiculous from our situation here, or at least a little bit of money. I'm not going to be too picky. Oh, fates. That's still real good. Okay. That is fantastic. I'm excited. And what is this? Magic Mush? Squeezy. That's still really good. This is actually, in terms of survivability, like, and utility, like, the flying item is amazing as well, but this is just a staggeringly useful start here. Very, very pragmatic and... Don't mind if I do pick up a little extra money here. We do have an opportunity to use Bob's Rotten Head to... Right, no keys. To get that tinted rock there. I don't know if we'll be able to do it without getting hit ourselves. But it might be worth getting hit in order to access a tinted rock. You would probably, like, the normal case is that you would probably expect to break even. You'd pick up one Spirit Heart and maybe a consumable. But if we could just pick up a bomb instead, that would probably be a little bit more preferable for us. Bob's Rotten Head, you know, I'm of two minds about this item. It's bad, but the reason that it's good for us right now is because we started with the poop, which is even worse, probably. Even though I know it's going to annoy some people to say that, Bob's Rotten Head is a bad item. People are usually a little bit more kind of just eh on the poop. Book of Sin is definitely better than either of them, I would say, but we will take Bob's Rotten Head at least temporarily, even though we'll probably take Book of Sin from this point on, or from this floor on. I at least want to be able to access some tinted rocks that otherwise might not have been possible. You know what? We take Book of Sin fairly frequently. Let's take Bob's Rotten Head for now. I don't think it's that big of an ask. Like, I don't know, if I try to like walk backwards while throwing it, I thought maybe it would have hit, but we've learned something about it now. Hopefully we'll just get a bomb or a key that allows us to get into the shop and buy a bomb. Even if we can't though, we don't really need to access the Tinted Rock, I would just like to, because as... I don't want to say Spirit Arts are useless, we could always end up using them in the future. And we can still hold them for now. But a small rock would be incredible if we could pick that up. And also, I would like to get a lot of keys, because you never know how these golden chests are going to work out for us here. Let's try, like, right here, maybe the best chance of getting a crawl space out of it. Okay, we got another bomb out of it, which is actually lovely. Was there a Tinted Rock back here? I just want to check to make sure. I don't believe that there was... But we might as well figure it out. No Tinted Rock. Okay. This is good. Does Blue Baby start with like a higher tier stat? Or am I just coming off of like a weird psychosis from that Missing No run where I was like, you know what? I have no idea. I don't understand at all what's happening on this run, but we're just gonna roll with it. That's another health upgrade, which is lovely. How do I feel about Bob's Rotten Head versus Book of Sin? I have always thought Book of Sin was better and Bob's Rotten Head was kind of trash, but I've never really committed to using it super offensively. Let's give it a try at least before I completely write it off. Just want to kill these guys first and, you know, maybe get Monstro in a more predictable position. I mean, that's not really that good. Only being able to take off a third of Monstro's HP is actually pretty terrible, but if we actually have the option to use this more often, like if we got AAA battery or a 9 volts, we could use it every 2 rooms, I could see it being more viable. Because I'm like, well, Mr. Boom is a 2-room charge, and Bob's Rotten Head is poison, and you can throw it, so, you know, you would expect it to maybe be a little bit more expensive charge-wise. Well, no precedent for us, and no items at all, but the pentagram is still great, so it gives us a better chance for deals with the devil in the future, but I'm a little disappointed we didn't get to trade away our HP. But anyway, you know, you're like, well, it has some advantages over Mr. Boom, but it also has some disadvantages compared to Mr. Boom. It might not be as mobile, but it is, like Mr. Boom, this is, also does more damage because it has, also does more damage because it has the Mr. Mega effect associated with it. So it's like, you know, I really think that maybe Bob's Rotten Head should be a 2-room charge to begin with, but it's a minor thing. Okay, well, that's good. I would say that it's fair to say I probably picked the right chest to open there. We got Cricket's Head. Hopefully we've chosen the right room. That was very dumb, because I could have... Wait, that's not the secret room. Okay, never mind, it's not as dumb as I thought it was. I was like, we could have just as easily gotten in here for free, but whatever. You know, by going into the other room. But that way is blocked off, so it has to be this way. Why not? That's okay. That's okay. 16 cents. We could have instead used the key to go to the shop and then Bob's Rotten Head to probably blow up the donation machine, but it was worth a shot, I think. We got Fate and Cricket's Head from these special chests already, so I'm very excited about this. Pretty much right on track if we want to, you know, think about doing Boss Rush, and we'll probably get a little bit faster. Figured we might as well try the mushroom there. We'll probably get a little bit faster as time goes on, a pun apparently unintended, but worked out nicely for us anyway, as a result of the fact that we have not only these speed upgrades, but also a very substantial set of damage upgrades right off the bat here. Small rock would really tie it together. That's alright. Another spirit heart this early doesn't hurt. Super Lust we have not fought in a little while, I think. Super Lust drops Yum Heart. Absolutely horrible for us, but good to know that it's out of here already, I guess. Well, actually, it doesn't get out of the rotation, but I guess it's just good to know that we got a charge for the room. I'm struggling to find positives there. But I'm struggling to find negatives as well. It's not like we took damage on the room or anything like that. That would have been a really good opportunity for a key to show up. I will try for the secret room here. It's not there. I wanted to see if maybe we could get... Oh, it's definitely not there. I didn't realize that it was not a dead end on the other side. Or that it was a dead end, I should say, on the other side. Tears downgrade, annoying, but again, our rate of fire is still okay. We did fall into kind of like a shitty equilibrium with our rate of fire a couple runs ago, but that's okay. We got nothing to worry about here because we have Cricket's Head, Pentagram, Squeezy right off the bat. So Squeezy, probably, even with that Tears downgrade, keeps us buoyed above or roughly at Blue Baby's starting tier stat. So at least it's not like below... I don't want to say maintenance, but you know what I mean. It's not below the starting threshold. I like the shoe being on the other foot here. That guy, like, stood still and was like, okay, I'm ready to fire now. No. You're ready to fire when I tell you. You're ready to fire. A few different ways out of this room. This is fine. Thank you. I really want as many exploded mushrooms as is possible. A magic mushroom pickup. You know, I've gotten lucky enough on this run that I believe a magic mushroom pickup could happen. But I'm gonna have to get them over to this side first. You gonna shoot? I don't think he's gonna shoot. That's alright. Are we not done? We're done. Check out what we have going on up here. No keys still. Have we been to our item room? I don't think we have. We could really, really use some keys. I also, for real, thought that that would not only kill that gurgling, but probably kill the gurgling that I thought was within close enough range to get hit by it. Apparently, I was grossly mistaken there in the range of Bob's Rotten Head. Look, I'm not going to say that Bob's Rotten Head is an incredible, amazing item, and well, we're so lucky to have it. I'm trying to find the positives here, and the game's making it a little tricky sometimes. At the very least, we're kind of experimenting with an item we don't get too many opportunities to experiment with. Shouldn't have taken this until we saw what was in our deal with the devil, but it's a relatively minor mistake. We can already fly, so I think we just take Dark Matter. We take Dark Matter because it gives us, well, not only the Fear Shot and the damage upgrade, but also Precedent. And that Precedent is what is chiefly important right now. Because now with the Pentagram, we can expect to get a lot of deals with the devil. I don't think we're going to be able to go to our item room or our shop on this floor. And that's very, very sad. I think we've been in every room. Sincerely. I'll take a quick little peek around, but I think we've been everywhere. Oh, no, that's not true. We haven't been down here. So there's still hope. We only need one key, or a couple of bombs works fine too, to start the threshold here, to cross the threshold here. I don't really want to use a bomb, or a Bob's Rotten Head, because I might be able to use this to get into the shop via the secret room, and if we were... Oh, bombs are key, maybe. Ah, range upgrade's also fine, but it's a little disappointing. We didn't do our mob trap room yet, so we can always... Oh, it's a golden chest, right, we looked. Okay, well, I gotta do some mental mapping now. This is not gonna be the secret room. Could this be the secret room? I'm gonna give it a shot, at least. Nope. With that not being the secret room, I guess we just look for a second secret room. And get out of here. Oh, maybe bombs are key. Tears up is great. Tears down is not. Tears up is great. Speed up is good. Range up is fine. Alright, we're out of here. I mean, we didn't get to the item room. We picked up two tiers upgrades, though, which is, I'm not gonna say similar, possibly even better, possibly worse, but... yeah, it makes me feel like maybe I shouldn't have used all those keys on the last floor, but, you know, you would expect to get a little bit luckier than that. Kind of feel like we got the short end of the stick a little bit. But a great pill rotation. I deserved a bad pill there for counting my chickens before they hatched, but... A great pill rotation is making me feel a little... It's taking the sting out a little bit, and of course, as is tradition, we will get a key immediately after not being able to open a door that might have opened our eyes a little bit here. Well, you know, again, some tweets, people were like, hey, stop talking about the streak so much. Hey, you know, I'm invested in the streak. We got two different kinds of people that are caring about the streak. We'll try Shoop the Whoop. You know, if this is going to be like the home for misfit toys, then we might as well go all in on it, you know? That was not very good damage, of course. And we will definitely open this. Honestly, the streak has... It's not like I ever fell out of love with Isaac, you know? I always mention that when I travel, I play this game all the time. Really makes the... You know, if you're flying, you got a long flight, it doesn't matter. Oh, it's not long anymore. Oh, an 8-hour flight? That's only like 9 Isaac runs. That's no big deal. Just another day at the office. But the streak has kind of, it's rejuvenated my zeal even further. It's ignited a fire that was already ignited as if pouring, you know, gasoline on top of it or something. I'm not very good with combustion. I've never been much of a, I've never had much of an interest in fire. I'm the guy who, if I was on, like, Survivor or Naked and Afraid or one of those survival shows, well, first off, something has gone, yeah, we'll take it. I'm confident in our survivability. If I'm on one of those shows, something has gone terribly wrong in the casting process. But they were like, okay, you know, what's your luxury item? People were like, I took a fire starter so that I don't have to worry about starting fire. I'd be like, I brought my Kindle because the battery life's good, you know? I'm not gonna make it out there. You're not gonna need me in a survival situation. But maybe, you know, I'm smart enough to lie about it. If I got in like a plane crash on a desert island, I'd be like, oh, I'm an orthopedic surgeon. Well, you know what, let's just say I'm a doctor. People be like, when am I gonna get a bone problem out here? You know, well, I guess you'd still have medical training. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It's getting a little bit too pedantic. This is fine. We can live with Mongo Baby at least. I'm very excited. I'm always a little nervous when I hit the random button. I'm always a little nervous when I play as Eden, or I know that I'm playing as Eden. Yeah, we'll take Black Candle as well. And I like this. I like it a lot because it kind of it makes it so every run carries more weight because it carries the weight of the runs preceding it, right? It's always these kind of, like, periods in Isaac where we can get kind of a storyline going as opposed to just a bunch of random runs. I like them both, I like playing the game. I've been playing it forever, and, you know, we haven't always had some kind of overarching narrative storyline to draw from, but to have a streak going like this really feels good. And again, after that, like, 20 streak, I didn't, or 25 streak, I didn't know if it would ever happen again, but here we are, and we're blowing the doors off of that 25 streak, slowly, meticulously approaching doubling it, which would feel really, really good. But we're going to take it one run at a time, and unlike the 25 streak where I really started to min-max and kind of betray the kind of player that I have been at certain occasions, we're just going for everything here, you know? Missing no? Give it to me, I don't care. D20? Well, sorry, D100? Well, sometimes. Let's not get too ridiculous here. I think we take them both. We only have one guppy item, and now we've hampered our HP a little bit, and this is really the death knell of many a blue baby run. Just blow them all up. It's the death knell of many a blue baby run is, taking way too many deals with the devil. Oh, thank you for that. However, I think that, both of those have their place. Wow, we got two spirit hearts out of that. That does not happen very often. If we got another one out of that, then someone up there really does not want us to lose this run, and that is appearing to be the case right now. Little slow for boss rush, but that's okay. I really need to revise my prospective times for those. Excuse me. Thank you. We will open this, and it worked out for us. Now Mom's Key is like an ideal pickup. So, yeah, you know, I guess in a roundabout way, what I'm trying to say is that I am patting myself on the back a little bit. I'm very happy with the way that these runs have gone, and I'm happy that we've gotten a good streak without betraying the way that I like to play the game, which is basically do whatever you want to do. Do whatever feels right. Even if you know that it's unlikely to work out for you. Sometimes you might get lucky. This feels like a template to me. Still a long way to go to get to, you know, my stated goal for 2015, which is at some point rattle off a 100 win streak. But what this makes me feel is that at least it's possible, you know? If we get like a kind of a perfect storm of situations going on, it's at least possible to think about a 100 win streak. It's not that ridiculous. We'd probably have to either beat the game with the loss at some point, again, or we would have to take the loss out of the rotation and use like a randomizer, which people suggest, but I don't want to do that in the middle of this streak, you know? I think one day we're going to have a great moment where the loss, hopefully I still have the streak going at this point, where the loss gets random and then I have like a really, really stressful situation, but I accept that at some point it'll probably, the feeling of the streak will probably vacate us, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it, so to speak. No Mom's Key. Fanny pack, when we have money, I think is fine, and that's a tiers upgrade. A range upgrade, you know, same thing if you don't think about it too hard. And Spoonbender with Death's Touch. This is still not, and I'm, it's admittedly a little bit of sandbagging here, but this is still kind of a, not a one run. Just because we don't have any kind of defensive item. Really, at least. Offensively, oh, that's good. Offensively, it's super, super good. Death's Touch, you know, Fear or Dark Matter specifically. The Pentagram, Cricket's Head, amazing. Defensively, we don't have very much going for us, except great luck when it comes to getting Spirit Hearts occasionally, so we're not fully set yet, but we're not super far away from it is the idea as well. Hey, we've already been to our shop. I'm just going to pop 2 of diamonds so I don't forget about it and, you know, fail to use it in an optimal situation. Nothing? No, there's something here. There they are. I forgot what was the driving force here. Hoping for... Yeah, we don't have, like, little baggy or anything like that. I'm hoping for a teleportation card, because boss rush is still theoretically possible. It's unlikely, but not outside of the realm of possibility for sure. And we do have a tinted rock here, which should take us back to full HP, or close, and a speed upgrade doesn't hurt either. What do we need on this run? Honestly, a miter pickup is pretty much it. Miter, relic, get rid of Pinky's Eye or Pinky Eye and take Mom's Pearl. Like, we're so close to being guaranteed, and that's what we need to be guaranteed. What we need to win is basically just don't take that much damage, and, you know, I think we can sell that, probably. That was a terrible room to use that on. But we are at the point where, like, Shoop the Whoop or Bob's Rotten Head, which we got rid of course, for that matter, but we're at the point where basically, like, Shoop the Whoop is not gonna do more damage than our tiers, but we'll still use it because it's got a little bit, you know, it's got a shot speed and range advantage, but It's not going to be particularly strong for us. But oh well, basically. We're saddled with it for now. We would take Krampus' head. You know, if you're listening, game. Might not be a bad opportunity. Ignore the sounds outside. It's just our robotic vacuum overlords coming to survey the world, perform reconnaissance for the day that they will one day rise up and defeat us as a race. Or as a species, sorry. 42 cents. Not much to do with it. 18 minutes. Yeah, we're pretty much screwed out of boss rush. We're not screwed, like it was fair, but we might as well get a move on here. We're gonna be like a minute too slow. But, you know, with the pentagram, I would be expecting a deal with the devil next floor. We've been very lucky with those over the course of this run, and honestly, I can't really complain at all. What would be nice, and you know what I'm gonna say, probably, is Guppy. We don't need it. We probably get it at, you know, to the point where it's so annoying. I can see forever, sure. But it would still be awesome to have it. You can't deny that. Alright, so this would be a great opportunity for Magic Mush to show up, or even a single pill. It's amazing how fast I will revise my my estimates. It's like, well, just give me like one of the best items in the game. Alright, how about literally anything? That is painful, and I didn't even get to open that, so that's annoying. We have not been good about our spirit hearts on this floor up to this point. Presumably, we will get a bomb or something, yeah, that we can use to access this. We can fly in. There's nothing wrong with that. All that for 3 cents is a little disappointing, I'm not gonna lie. And what's our other pills? Like, bad gas? We might as well take it, but it's not particularly solid. Boss rush now basically mathematically fading away from us as well. Again, not really a big problem. We already have the items that I want to get out of boss rush most of the time. Death's Touch combined with the ability to... not the ability to fly, but that is always nice, of course. Death's Touch combined with homing shots. Northern Lion, why aren't you going to that double key room? I'm intending on going to the double key room. Just want to soften these guys up a second. I'm intending on going to the double key room. However, well, that might get a spirit heart. Not quite. However, we need a few more keys. I need to be able to go to the shop. I need to be able to go to the item room. So, like, one more key will make that double key room a possibility. And if it's a reroll room, we'll go for it. You know, we've had good luck with that kind of stuff thus far. It's almost unfathomable that it would be better than the current run we have, but I think it's not worth a shot, and there's our fourth key. Could open the golden chest instead, but let's throw caution to the wind here. You never know. If we're missing boss rush, this could be a 5-room, which would be really nice. Holy crap. We have the magnet, obviously. Bob's Brain, Relic. Tech 2 quad shot, but like maybe soy milk? Is our damage as bad as I feel like it might be? Because the tears are really impressive. How's the damage? Not completely terrible. So, you know what? Yeah, we'll take this. I'm actually still pretty happy with this run. It did get worse, but it's not awful. We don't fly anymore, so it's like not the worst idea to take the Bible, but I really don't want to like accidentally use it on bosses that could get me killed. Let's oh, that's 2 bad gas pills, not worth it. Why did I go into the one room without even saying anything? Because I know if I started to talk, I probably would have talked myself out of it, you know? I would have been like, oh, we've got this great run, I've worked for it, we had the missing no run on the last time. I had to do it like Band-Aid style and just pull off the bandage. Thank you, Relic. Before I could talk myself out of it, because I'm positive that I would have. So that's... Oh, we have, like, some kind of weird cricket's body going on, despite the fact that we, yeah, that's... I mean, it is what it is. We have this weird cricket's body thing going on, despite the fact that we don't actually have any tears. Might as well use the Bible to kill Mom. That's a no-brainer. No deal with the devil, because the deal with the devil meta gets all messed up here. That's okay. I'm still happy with it. Let's make this run work. It's gonna be... The sound is gonna be annoying, man. And we do suffer from a little bit of a damage issue here. I'll give you that. We have sad bombs? Is that what's making Bob's? Yeah! That is what's making... Oh, we do have soy milk. That's so funny. Sad bombs is what's making Bob's brain explode in that weird but also interesting way. So it's yet another soy milk run. And again, I take these runs, like, not only because it's fun, but also to insulate me from those complaints of, like, oh, Northern Lion, you used to be absurd. Now you just care about winning. Yo, I just rerolled, like, a one run with Death's Touch. Cricket's Head. Lots of great items in the freaking soy milk technology too. So if you want to step to me on that, you best bring some exhibits A through Z, because I am, in my opinion, showing a commitment to absurdity. Okay. And again, we can't just have a normal run, can we? We can't just have your standard, you know, high damage, high rate of fire, or brimstone, or mom's knife, or something like that. We have to get this ridiculous nonsense going on here, otherwise it apparently does not count anymore. This is the most annoying sound. What if we get Libra, though? Like, let's focus on the positives. I mean, there's not really huge negatives. It's actually still a decent amount of damage considering that soy milk is involved on this run. You know, these enemies are fairly tanky. Obviously, it's not as much DPS as we were doing on the last run, but those enemies are fairly tanky, and we're still taking them out, you know? It's not taking 100 years. It's not super speedy either, but it could be a lot worse. In the meantime, let's make our way through here. And, you know, we did blow up a judgment, so I would be expecting a decent chance at a deal with the devil. I do want to, if possible, get Bob's brain out of my face. But the enemies keep moving. One of these weird situations where we have, like, infinite range, but it's almost in my best interest to get right up against an enemy. Not a very smart idea. It's in our best interest to get, like, right up against an enemy, because when we do, like, all four lasers hit them reliably. Maybe not the smartest call, though. This is a room where having the ability to fly is gonna save me a lot of heartache, I think. Pheromones. Somewhat ironically, maybe. Pheromones is a really great play on a room like this, but we were already, like, halfway done by the time it manufactured itself there. Oh, right, I can't fly. We do have permanent Polaroid invincibility as well, which is an important part of a balanced breakfast. Not gonna be too interested in dealing with that. Okay, the poison damage is enough. Watch out for the... Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Then we just blow it up. There's one more. Now we can take our leisure time on this room. You know, I don't think we need to stand next to enemies. It doesn't seem like it does that much of a damage bonus for us to do that. And I'm expecting a spirit heart here, which we did indeed get. All right, let's do this. Blast assist. Hey, you know, there's going to be two different kinds of bosses for us. Ones that we would be better off with our last run. Well, probably damage-wise, we'd always be better off with our last run. But, you know, bosses that are really tanky and bosses that are kind of like, you know, you can hit them multiple times with the same shot. And that's pretty much what we've got going on here. I think we benefited a lot from that. And we get a second guppy item. And we might as well take it because we're going to be able to get back to the HP cap. And you never know if survivability is going to be an issue. You know, maybe a respawn will help us out. Probably not. One of those, it looked like it had a big laser. I was a little concerned and confused about this. So what do we do now? Well, I mean, I guess you try to insulate your ears from the fact that there's this terrible noise coming out. And then we, this might be Tech 1, by the way. This might not be Tech 2. It's hard to distinguish them because our rate of fire is so high, but, in fact, I think it is Tech 1. Because of the, it sounds like it's firing rapidly, not continuously, if that makes sense, but near continuously. Functionally, it's firing continuously. Might as well, you know, pick up some consumables here. Why not? Was it worth the Bible charge? I'm probably not going to use the Bible very much from this point on, because I never really committed to memory what bosses it actually kills you instantly against. I'm assuming it's like Satan, Isaac, but I'd rather be safe than sorry, you know? Like, I'm not even going to use the Bible against Mom's Heart. I think it'll be a little bit of a risk, but I don't think it'll kill us. I think it's just, you know, it'd be nice to have the practice. And why risk a 42 streak on something that I'm not 100% confident about, you know? We're in a good enough position that this is fine. It would be so funny to actually get, Well, that's pretty good for the cathedral, at least, but it would be so good to get into that curse room and get Guppy. With this soy milk run. These Guppy attacks, or the flies, I should say, would be doing, like, no damage, but we'd have about a trillion of them on the screen at all times. If there's a secret room, it would be about here, roughly, so I think we're just gonna have to go to the curse room for ourselves. That's alright. Didn't work out. We got our spirit heart back, and there's another spirit heart over here. Also got a golden key, but we don't have the effect of Guppy's tail anymore. We just have the guppiness of Guppy's tail. You never know when these keys are gonna come in handy. Alright! We've explored the entirety of this part of the floor. I'm actually... Like, I don't necessarily want to call it because this run's so weird, but it looks like this should be a pretty much guaranteed win. Big plays for us in the cathedral, or big items for us to get. Not the cathedral, sorry. Well, I mean, yes, the cathedral, because we have the Joker card, but on the chest, an orbital, like Sacrificial Dagger, would be amazing. Nah. Because we have so much invincibility, that would help. On top of that, I would love to get, I guess, literally any damage upgrade. But really, like, a Sacrificial Dagger pickup would mean a lot to me. Alright, back it up here before we get hit. I mean, it's not a great sign that it's taken us forever to kill Loki, but I actually like this infinite range, kind of, like, super fast shot speed run combined with Bob's Brain. We can stand on the other side of the map, hit an enemy, and then when Bob's Brain shows up, just, you know, whenever it hits. Just keep ourselves as far out of harm's way as we can possibly get. Thought maybe we had a Spirit Heart coming. Must be next room. I was also, I'll admit, kind of hoping that our double key room would be a reroll. But I guess in reality, I'm actually glad that it's not. Because this is a one run, it's just an annoying kind of one run. You gotta be very careful about Bob's Brain here. There we go. Yeah, it's just a weird kind of one run. It's not a bad run, necessarily, it's just unusual. And it's, I'm not gonna say it's impossible for us to be killed, but it's unlikely that we get, oh, that was extremely stupid. It's unlikely that we get killed because of the relic, basically. All we need to do is have a few good rooms and then the relic is, oh, we might as well use it here. All we need to do is have a few good rooms and then the relic works out just fine for us. So this is one of the situations now where, even though I'm in new meta, where I don't really like to play the judgments and I prefer to blow them up for the deal with the devil chance, Womb 2 judgment with a lot of money is a perfect opportunity to play because we have nothing to lose, basically, except money, which is effectively pretty much worthless. I'm gonna take the pills instead of the Bible. We know that there are, I'm gonna take the Joker card as well. We know that there are health up pills in our rotation, tears ups, range ups, you know, a variety of things. Right, I can't fly. Variety of things of that sort. So I'm gonna be happy to have it, I think. Now, the most important thing, and I want to articulate this, I need to, yeah, get this Bob's Brain out of here. Most important thing for the next floor, and I need to articulate this quickly so that I don't mess it up, is, man, this is really just going to be Bob's Brain doing the damage, huh? Is that I really cannot afford to take shit deals with the devil on the cathedral just because they're there. It needs to be a deal with the devil that actually provides us with some benefit. It turns us into Guppy or, you know, something of the sort. Abaddon does do that, and we'll just pick it up, and we get, like, okay, we're at max HP, and then this will help out as well. So, that's a nice damage bonus for us, without a doubt. Still pretty slow. Still taking a little while to kill enemies, but it's better. You see that? My game temporarily froze there for a minute, or my brain temporarily froze there for a minute. Probably a sign that I should really get on picking up a new PC. This, you know, it's like an old race car. It can still go real fast, but one day, you know, the transmission's gonna fall out and leave you dead on the freeway, so I would probably at least start looking for, like, a new hard drive, but, you know, this beauty's run its course, I think. Thank you for all you've done for me. We will check this out because it would be awesome to become Guppy. We did not become Guppy, but we picked up some spirit hearts in the process, which we can't actually use immediately, but one day, perhaps. And you can see, like, we're much faster against Chubb than we were on the last floor, I think. And even when we fought Larry Jr., like, that's a decent amount of damage to be doing to Larry Jr. We would love to just be one-shotting him at this point in the run, but, you know, that's just not in the cards for us right now. We can live with it like this instead, and I think be fine. Money equals power would be a huge help for us, too, if we could actually get it on the next floor. I don't think we will, but, you know, if we could. If we have to go to the curse room, you know, out of our own pocket, there's nothing wrong with that at this point. We have a spirit heart awaiting us in the next room anyway. Would it be here? It's fine. Flat penny, huh? I mean, Pinky Eye is... it's pretty good. It's not doing amazing work for us necessarily, but it's alright. We're gonna keep it. And we have 9 keys, and I don't expect a lot of golden chests to be showing up on the next floor. You know, we have Guppy's Tail, but we don't have Guppy's Tail anymore. We just have the fact that we picked up Guppy's Tail stored in memory somewhere. Tears Up is probably literally meaningless. Unless there's no cap on tears, I would assume that we're like at the cap on tears. Nope. I can actually demonstrably feel that we're firing a little bit faster now, which is kind of ridiculous. Alright. So again, this is unlosable. They alive, damn it. It's a miracle. But, well, we'll save that for the next floor. We might as well play with good fundamentals as well, because I'll be coming back with an Eden run next. And, you know, Eden is totally random. At least to start with. And then on our Isaac run, we picked up Missing No. And then on our Blue Baby run, we reset and we re-rolled it. And this is coming off the back of, like, some ridiculously kind of challenging runs, at least by my standards, that we had in the middle of it. So, I'm feeling like we're still due for, like, just a brimstone, no re-roll room kind of run. Would that kill you? I don't think it would kill you to give me a, like, hey, brimstone and then a 5 room. So we can do that floor all over again. I'm not complaining, you know, as long as we're winning, I'm not gonna complain. However, like, work with me a little bit here. Well, Bob's Brain really helping us out here. As is a punching bag, actually. I really appreciate what it's doing for me right now, which is effectively making it so that I don't have to dodge very often, which is actually really, really nice. Try a sad bomb in it. It's actually really, really nice because when I dodge, I can't hit the enemy. I have to stay on line of sight with them. Get Bob's... oh, that's so dumb, but get Bob's Brain in there. Beautiful. And, you know, this is the other thing. We have sad bombs. We have to try to use sad bombs as often as possible because they're really, really effective. And if we get, like, I don't know, anything that gives us huge damage, then sad bombs becomes even better on top of that. So we lost 1 HP there, but I'm not concerned, really. And I don't think I should be concerned. Let's see if I'm correct in this. No curse. Amazing. Daddy Longlegs, Dad's Key, My Reflection, Game Kid. I think we take My Reflection because it's like weird. It'll make Sad Bombs weird. Dad's Key, we'll make a decision on. I'm so happy for Daddy Longlegs. Dad's Key, you know, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. I did avoid fighting Mega Satan recently. Ha ha ha, no. I did avoid fighting Mega Satan recently because we were, like, underpowered. I still kind of feel that way, but also Dad's Key showed up on the chest. It's almost like a dare, isn't it? I'm almost like, how can I say no to this? But I kind of want to explore a little bit first to give myself the option. We're gonna get a second lard pickup, which seems bad, but our speed is fine, so actually that second lard pickup is basically just like more HP waiting for us when we need it. Lard is such a minor speed down, if I remember correctly. It's like negative 0.3 or 0.5. Somewhere in that vicinity, so it's not like it's a huge problem for us either way. And again, our speed is good to great right now, regardless of this. It's a really good sign that these rooms are going as quickly as they are. Well, it's weird, because I don't like to shy away from absurdity in the game. But I'll admit, it's scary to be put in a position where it's basically like, if you fight this boss, you might be making the decision that gets you killed, I guess. But, hey, that's life. Yeah, there's a penny back there. Whatever. We have gotten a couple of one item drop that was bounded by luck. So I'm assuming that, you know, if we get one, we have a chance to get some more. That's what I'm hoping for, really, is the opportunity to just get a little stronger. A Mr. Mega pickup would be really nice. Like, sad bombs plus Mr. Mega plus the opportunity to get more bombs. We could always take, not very smart there. We could always take Game Kid in with us to the boss fight, but honestly, I don't think that makes a huge difference. But we did get an item. And full health, which does nothing, I'm assuming. Our item is flush. It's not very good. Yep, as indicated there. I thought maybe you would do something a little bit better than that for us, but so be it. Oh, come on. This guy's, like, rested right up against the wall. I find this a little rich. This is why you never give the game an inch, man. They take a mile. Oh, you're going to reroll your one run? How about this? How about we give you Dad's key on the chest, you scumbag? I'm taking his tears down. You never know. I can't fire because Bob's rotten head. You never know. We could end up encountering PhD. So one time there was Fear Shot. I respect that. What the heck happened the other time? Range up. I mean, with my reflection, this might make Sad Bomb slightly better, but it's probably, as you might expect, not the pill I was hoping for there. What is the pill I'm hoping for? That's a good question. I actually don't fully know what I'm looking for in this life. Watch out for Bob's Rotten Head. It's not back yet. It's back! Okay. That was actually a really well-handled room. This is I Can See Forever, which we've already used, so we would, if we found secret rooms, or if we saw secret rooms, we'd be expecting to identify them already. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. You gotta, like, what? Sorry, excuse me? 2 feet coming down at the same time? I call bullshit on that. No, sorry. Like I said, you give the game an inch, they take a mile, man. Fuck it, let's get to full HP and fight Mega Sage. Oh, don't... What the hell are you doing here, Knight of the Roxbury, Eric Criscatan? Rainbow Fudgin' Baby. That is not specifically what I'm looking for. Okay, well, I mean, here we go, man. Let's fucking do it. When are we gonna use, Oh, man. When are we going to use Game Kid? Probably on the multiple mini-boss, I think. We've already Sorry, what? You created a hollow since when? Yo, you know what my favorite Winter Olympic sport is? The fucking slalom. That's obviously a joke. It's ice hockey. What is going on? You are not supposed to be attacking at the same time I'm fighting the mini-bosses, you know? Like, there's a little bit of bullshit happening here that I do not... Is it actually that I'm just doing so much damage? Or, like, isn't this the first wave? I don't understand what's happening. I mean this sincerely. I'm not just trying to play up a character or something like that. I don't get it. He's doing attacks on us when he should not be able to do attacks on us. In my, you know, personal opinion, at least. But I didn't program the game. I don't know what's going on with the scripting here. Some fucking conditional statements got lost in translation. Like a Sofia Coppola film. Coppola? Coppola? I don't know. People are gonna be like, it's Coppola. You know, man. You haven't been to their family Thanksgiving. You don't know what they prefer to be called. You just know what you heard on TV. So I think we don't use it here. I think we use it, oh, jeez. When we're about to walk over... I should have used it right there. I was going to say when we're about to walk over the creep, but, you know, we can also use it here. And it's doing something. It did almost nothing. But at least we were briefly invincible. Why stand there in the middle of that shot? That's real bad. We're still not going to die. After the angel statues, it's very quick for us to get down to the next section. And then it'll be a little difficult because we've got to be in Mega Satan's grill. But we'll also have the opportunity to completely, you know, vacate our sad bombs all over his dome. Sad bombs is a great euphemism for ejaculate. Yo, girl, I'm about to let loose with my sad bombs. Yo, don't ever say that, but you can think about it next time. And when you do, think of me, and I'll spoil your moment. Alright. We only had triple shot, by the way. I was calling it quad shot, like, the whole run. But, you know, really, what's the difference, man? If 2 out of 3 ain't bad, 3 instead of 4 is fine. I think, my favorite Meatloaf song.
3 out of 4 is fine.
That was more Michael McDonald, but, you know, Michael McDonald is made out of meatloaf, so I'll accept it. I guess I'm just gonna get hit there. Where's my sad bombs at? We killed him already, man. That was more damage than I thought. Well, thanks for watching. That was a scary run. I hope I at least adhere to some commitment to absurdity. We're gonna be back with an Eden run next. Thanks for watching. That'll be win 43. On our way to 50, thanks for watching again, and if you like the video, show your support, and I will see you next time.